Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about what are the requirements of a bioprocess. We already know what a bioprocess is. So a bioprocess is a process in which we are deriving a product from living cells, okay? And this question we discussed in the first video, what is bioprocess technology, or what are the importance of a bioprocess technology subject. So now we are going to study about the requirements of a bioprocess, or what it takes for a bioprocess to be carried out. Okay, so bioprocess is a process in which from living cells we are deriving a product. So our first thing that we need is living cells. Okay, so where do you get these living cells from? Where do you get that particular species of cells that you want? So you go to a cell bank, ask them for your particular species of cells, they'll give you a small vial of cells. But again, there is another problem, because you are manufacturing product on an industrial scale. Okay, you are manufacturing product on an industrial scale, so you need hundreds or thousands of kgs of biomass of that particular cell. Okay, so first you need cells, you go to cell bank, you get a small vial of cells from there, and now you grow these cells. Because you need thousands of kgs of biomass of cells, okay? So you grow these cells. But there are certain requirements that needs to be fulfilled if you want to grow cells, okay? So there are certain requirements that needs to be fulfilled if you want to grow cells. You need to provide them optimum conditions. You need to provide them best suitable conditions so that they can divide, they can proliferate, okay? So, and that environment, with those particular conditions, with those best conditions for the cells, is known as biologically active environment. That environment is known as biologically active. That is, now you are providing cells an environment in which they can be biologically active. Now we need to study what constitutes a biologically active environment, or what are the properties of a biologically active environment. And the first thing and the most important thing is sterility. That is, the environment needs to be sterile. There should not be any other microorganism except the microorganism of our choice. Okay, so first thing is sterility. The second thing is nutrients. You need to provide cells with the particular type of nutrients, the particular type of nutrient that they require. Okay, one species of microorganism may require dextrose as their carbon source, while other species may require glucose as their carbon source. So you need to provide them nutrients in optimum amount and that particular kind of nutrient. Okay, and the third thing is temperature. Enzymes in any body work only at optimum temperature. So different microorganisms have different enzymes which may work at 50 degrees Celsius or 20 degrees Celsius or 70 degrees Celsius or whatever it is. Okay, so you need to find what is the optimum temperature for our particular microorganism, and we need to provide them that particular temperature. And also in the same way, we need to provide this fourth parameter, that is pH. The pH is also responsible, or the pH is plays an important role in functioning of enzymes. So if the enzymes, or if the pH is too high or too low, it may cause the malfunction of enzyme or not non-functioning enzymes. But we want the cells to be metabolically active, we want the cells to be continuously proliferating, continuously dividing, we want the cells to be growing. So we want that the enzymes inside the microorganism are working at the maximum rate. That is, the temperature for those enzymes should be optimum, the pH for those enzymes should be optimum. And the last thing is oxygen level. So we need to provide oxygen rich air to those microorganisms, because we don't want that the microorganisms suffer or struggle for oxygen. Okay, so we need to provide them good amount of oxygen or huge amount of oxygen so that they can profusely divide, they can proliferate, they can grow. Now all these conditions maintaining in a lab when we are culturing a small amount of cells is not very difficult. Okay, you can take a sterile petri dish, and the environment in which you are working should also be sterile so that there is no contamination. So you take a sterile petri dish and then you put some nutrients in it, and the nutrient media which you put in it, nutrient media is a liquid which contains the nutrient, and that liquid should be of particular pH. Okay, so you put that nutrient media in it and then you inoculate it with the cells which you got from the cell bank. So the cells which you got from the cell bank, so these are the cells which you got from the cell bank, and you put them here. Okay, so you inoculate it with these cells which you got from the cell bank, and now you put it in an incubator. You put it in an incubator, and what would incubator do? Incubator will maintain temperature, incubator will maintain oxygen level. So once you put it in into an incubator, you wait for some days or whatever. So the time of dividing, the time it takes for a cell to divide is different in different microorganisms. So you incubate it for certain time period, and after that particular time period you look into, you get, take the petri dish out of the incubator and you look into it and you find that the cells are growing. Okay, you find that the cells are dividing, or there is now a huge amount of cell biomass present. Now it is confirmed that the environment which you are providing is perfect for their growth. The temperature which you are providing, the pH which you are providing is perfect, or the nutrients which you are providing is perfect for their growth, because we can see that in a lab these microorganisms are growing, these microorganisms are dividing. But another problem is we don't want this much amount of microorganism. We don't want a few petri dishes of microorganism. What we want is thousands of kgs of microorganisms. So when we are talking about thousands of kgs of microorganisms, we need an equipment, we need a structure which can hold that much amount of microorganism and which can also maintain this biologically active environment. And there is a structure, there is an equipment which was designed around 80-90 years back, and that equipment is known as bioreactor. That equipment is known as bioreactor. So what is bioreactor? Bioreactor is a container which maintains biologically active environment. Bioreactor is a container which maintains all these parameters so that the cells inside bioreactors would grow, would proliferate, so that we can get or we can derive our product from those cells. So a bioreactor is a container which maintains biologically active environment. In the next video, we are going to study how does a bioreactor function and what are the different parts of a bioreactor. In the description, I have given a few questions. Please go through those questions, mention your answers in the comment, and we'll get back to you with correct answers. And also, if you have any questions, any suggestions, any queries, please do not forget to mention them in comments. Thanks.